What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Monkey Flop here, and today I'm going to be going through how to get the Platinum Trophy on Mortal Kombat 11 very, very easy. Now, big shout out to WB Games and NetherRealm Studios for giving me a free copy of the game early. Much appreciated. That is super awesome. Now, let's go ahead and discuss the trophy list, because honestly, this game is really easy in regards to trophies. Now, there are some games, that do require a lot more skill. This one, you can do it very easy, and I get a method for you for that as well. Even though I say it's easy, there's definitely going to be a grind, and it's going to take some time. But nevertheless, very, very easy trophies from what we've seen so far. Now, nobody's obtained the Platinum Trophy. We're waiting for the full game to get released for some of the trophies, but we're actually going to dive right into it right now. So, complete the tutorials. Those are easy ones. Those should come without a problem. Spill 10,000 pints of blood. You don't have to really worry about this trophy. This trophy is going to come naturally with playing the game. So, don't even think about it. Eventually, you're going to get it. In fact, you'll probably get it during, playing the story mode. Perform 30 different fatalities. This is going to come naturally as well. Perform 1,000 brutalities. You're actually going to have to try for this one because brutalities are actually a little bit more rare than fatalities. We're going to discuss that in just a second. Show mercy 10 times. This one's ultra rare. Not too many people like to show mercy. Some of the trophies I still have to obtain, but I wanted to talk about them here today. So open 200 crypt chests. This is going to come just with a grind, and you'll be able to obtain this honestly without a problem, just a lot of playing Mortal Kombat. Play 50 casual verse matches. Now, you can do this locally with against an AI, or if you get a second controller, you play with friends. If you play with a friend, you're going to get this pretty quick. The story mode is the first thing that I actually recommend you guys go and play. It's a lot of fun, and you'll get the trophy with no problem. You can play on the easiest level, easiest setting if you want, and still obtain the trophies for the story mode. There's only two for that one. You pay 100 total respect points to King of the Hill. This is an online one, so I recommend you guys get this one out of the way sooner rather than later, especially with online trophies. Now, the towers is something else we're going to talk about in here in a second. This one, you literally just have to complete a classic tower. This one, you actually have to complete one of these, either a warrior or classic tower with 10 different characters. And this is also going to come with, just grinding out another trophy we're going to talk about in a second. So, hit the gong in the crypt. Now, hit the gong in the crypt is very easy. Literally the first place that you guys should open up in the crypt, we'll have the gong, and you'll be able to just dong, hit it, no problem whatsoever. It's not that hard to find either. Now, this is the one that I believe is going to cause the most grind, and that's complete 250 towers. Keep in mind, you can play on the easiest setting, and you can play against five different characters in the classic tower mode, and you'll be able to obtain this fairly easy. But it will be at a grind, because usually, let's say you play on the easiest difficult setting. Each time you play is about 5 minutes. I recommend what I'm doing myself is trying to do 10 towers a day. That way I don't overwhelm myself with just towers and I'm actually enjoying the game with like other game modes. But I'm doing 10 towers a day, usually 5 minutes at a time. That's almost an hour of gameplay in itself. I recommend you doing that if you're grinding for that. Flip stances 50 times. Literally just go into, against AI or plug in another controller and just flip your stances 50 times. You'll be able to get this within less than, a minute's time. And then you group battle with two other players. This one's ultra rare, but very easy to get. And now here comes the fatalities. Now, the fatalities, you have to do fatalities with each and every character, but they are very easy to get. And the way that I'm telling you guys is the easiest to get is because you don't even have to unlock the fatalities and perform them yourselves if you don't want to. If you're into AI battles, you can actually just go into AI, and as you guys are seeing right here, select the characters that you need to get the trophies for, and then battle a couple of times with the characters, and eventually they're gonna perform their two fatalities, and you could just do this in AI mode, and you don't have to even unlock anything whatsoever. So that's one thing that I definitely recommend. That's how I've gotten a couple of mine in the trophy list, because I haven't even unlocked two fatalities for one character yet, but as you guys can see, I do have some of the trophies already unlocked. So I usually do AI battles when I'm editing videos or doing other things, just that way I can actually rank up as well, because it's actually really easy to just put on an AI battle and rank up that way as well. Defeat an opponent with Bug Vora. You duck 100 times. This is another easy one to get. Play 25 AI battle simulator sets. So for me, because I did notice that the fatalities trophies were unlocking in the AI mode, I decided to just continue playing AI. That way you can get all the trophies, and this should come naturally to you as well. Run 5 miles in the crypt. Now, some people are going to tell you can put rubber bands on your controller and just run around. Leave the controller down for about like 10 minutes and run around and you'll get it. But literally, there's no need for that. You're going to be unlocking 200 chests in the crypt. So my magic shoes trophy is going to unlock very, very easy. Equip 5 different character intros, 5 different victories. You get 50 consumables and use 100 consumables. Now, consumables unlock, as you progress through the game. Some of them will, you'll get consumables when you complete towers or story. You also get consumables when you go and open up loot boxes within the crypt as well. So this one should come naturally as well. Spear 50 hanging bodies in the crypt. You have to get the spear, and once you get it, you'll be able to find the hanging bodies. Very easy. Impale a head in the warrior shrine. This is going to come like later on. You're going to unlock the warrior shrine. That one should come very easy. Spend 50,000 coins in that shrine. I'm not sure exactly how to pronounce that name, but give me that money. Every time I go into the crypt and I spend money in the crypt, which is just in-game currency you get naturally through progressing through the story mode and through towers and different things like that. Every time I go in, I usually have like 50,000 to 70,000 to spend, so that should come easy. And reach the credits. You can actually just play the credits and get the trophy, or you can, beat the story mode like I did and get it that way. But overall, the trophies in Mortal Kombat 11 are very, very easy to obtain. I'm pretty sure a lot more people are going to be obtaining this platinum trophy as opposed to like previous fighting platinum trophies, just because of the nature and how easy it is, especially with the fatalities and the AI mode being able to unlock them very easy. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys so much for watching this video here today. If you guys do appreciate my kind of in-depth talk about the trophies, let me know in those comments down below, and I will see you guys in the next news update. Oh, and big shout out again to WB Games and NetherRealm Studios for giving your boy a free copy of the game. I will see you guys in the next news update. You guys are freaking awesome.